first question from Eric. He says, Phil, I admire your honesty and hope you can answer my question since you're quite open about this. I know you'll probably get this a lot, but what's up with you and John Rambo? Did you have a falling out? Is it because you two are far away? I'd like to hear your thoughts on the matter. Thank you. The bottom line is this. I will tell you completely 100% honest with you. And, you know, people will probably try to make shit up or say they don't believe me because they want to believe drama queen shit. The bottom line is this. When I lived in Connecticut for years, John and I did co-op commentary, co-op gameplay. We did this show Smart Guys. We traveled together. We did Street Fighter gameplay together. We did a lot of stuff, projects and everything together. In all of that time, all right, in all of the time that we did that stuff together, I could think of maybe 1 to 2 times ever that we ever had a disagreement on something. And even then, it was something that was minor and that was handled quickly. And it wasn't that we ever let it get to the point where business would hinder friendship. You know what I mean? And I think that's kind of the big risk that you take when you go into business with someone, that it might negatively affect the relationship that you have the person outside of the business. And even though we treated the whole YouTube thing that we did together as like just a casual, silly thing, there was money involved and there were other factors involved. The bottom line is, never in that entire period of time before I moved out of Connecticut did I ever get any, you know, ever have any ill will or feelings toward John. Never did he have any real major ill will or feelings towards me that I knew of. He never said anything about money. You know, he got paid for everything that he was involved in. He never said anything about money or anything like that. And we had great agreements that were going on. And when we left it, when I left Connecticut, where we left it at, was that I was going to move here. It was going to take me a couple months to get set up everything with work or whatever. But I was going to contact him in early fall, let him know when I was fully up and running again. And that I wanted to continue to do stuff, whether it was Smart Guys via Skype and gameplay, you know, cooperatively over the internet. And obviously, John didn't have a PlayStation 4 or an Xbox One, and we were going to try to coordinate it and figure out what could he or couldn't he do for gameplay. Would we do stuff last gen? Would there be other stuff? We were going to figure it all out, okay? And that's where we left it. Now, John came, he helped me pack all the stuff up when I was leaving in June of last year. He came and helped pack up and helped me move out of my place in Connecticut, okay? And we stayed in contact. I talked to him via text a lot. We were talking about different things going on with the move. I talked to him about TV shows and stuff going on. I was asking him about what was going on with Schnoz Man, a Hole Punch, and we stayed in contact regarding that. And the way we left it was that later in the year, once he was done with Schnoz Man, a Hole Punch, we were going to talk again about the possibility of coming back together and doing content over the internet again. And then in late 2014, finally, we had a conversation. He says, listen, I'm going to make this abundantly clear, you know, so there's no misconceptions. At this point, I'm kind of burnt out on the whole YouTube thing. I really don't even want to put a lot of effort into my stuff. I put all this effort into Schnoz Man, a Hole Punch, and that's really where I exerted all of my effort, and that's what I focused on, and that's really all I really care about at this point. I mean, it was cool that we did all the YouTube stuff previously, but I don't really care to be, you know, involved with anything from your YouTube channels at this point, and if that changes, I'll let you know. I said, okay, fine, I won't even bring it up if you don't, right? There's no reason for us to really bring it up or anything any further. And then I remember as last year progressed even further, I would text him, and every once in a while he would text me back. It was like we were almost losing touch. We didn't have as much contact. Now, if you remember, traditionally I would be on John's podcast for the Black Friday episode. Every year he would have like a special Black Friday episode where they go through ads and stuff about Black Friday. And last year in particular, I hadn't heard from him, so I'd actually texted him and said, FYI, John, I'll be available if you want me to be on, but I haven't heard from you yet, so I'm assuming maybe you don't want me to be on or whatever. That's fine. And he never really responded. I didn't really hear from him much. I wished him a Merry Christmas later that year. He did respond to that. And then less and less I heard from him. It wasn't like there was any argument, there was a falling out or anything. None of that happened. So if anything actually happened behind the scenes with John or Howard or whatever happened with the people back in Connecticut, right, who I used to do stuff with all the time, it's 100% on their end. And it was never actually brought to my attention at all. So I am completely in the dark in this situation. What ended up happening was I did continue to once in a while contact John on stuff. And sometimes he would respond and sometimes he wouldn't. And I actually remember the last major time that I actually had any kind of interaction with John Rambo was In early 2015, he launched the DVD, the Blu-ray release of Schnoz Man a Hole Punch. And when he did release it, I retweeted him. I let everyone know, gee, you should maybe buy some of this. I bought a DVD myself. And he even signed it. You know, I guess every DVD he sold, he signed it. And he actually wrote on there, thanks for all the good times that we had together. You know, John. So that was the signature he put on the DVD. Does that sound like anything negative? No, that sounds great. Like, he's like, you know, it sucks that we don't do stuff together anymore because you moved. But thanks for the good times we had. That's literally like what he wrote on the DVD. And then after that, I have no clue. I've not heard from John since then. He doesn't ever write me. He doesn't call me. He doesn't text me. Nothing. And I did try actively to contact him and talk to him over the course of the year. And basically, I heard nothing whatsoever from John Rambo at all since then. So I have no idea what happened. If something happened in particular that turned him off or got him angry at me. The bottom line is it's never been brought up. And I'm going to say this, and I hope that people don't take this the wrong way. But in life, if you have something that you want to say or you have an issue with someone, all right, say it. Bring it up. Hash it out. Don't let resentment build up behind the scenes for whatever amount of time or whatever. Because that's what happens. Is then, if something happens and you don't bring it up and you let resentment build up, that's when relationships get ruined, right? And the bottom line is, did I ever get hear or even get wind of anything negative from John or Howard or anyone from that camp who I used to do stuff with in Connecticut until I moved? No, not once. And in fact, we even had the big going away party in June of last year, and they all came. They were all there. We had fun. We had a blast together. We were drinking. We were playing games, eating, having a lot of fun. And it was like nothing's wrong. And then all of a sudden, once I moved, it was like, that's it. Well, Phil's gone. So now he's out of our lives. It almost feels like to me like they're saying, well, he abandoned us. You know, we used to do all this fun stuff together. He's not here anymore. So now we're mad at him or something. I don't know. But it is, again, it's speculation. Anything that I could possibly say about a John Rambo situation is pure an utter speculation, because I've been completely in the dark over the whole situation since it began, if it ever began. So that's why people want to start all this fucking shit, right? All this drama and controversial shit. They must have had a disagreement about money. Phil must have revealed something really personal or something. Nothing ever happened, at least from my side, zippo. I was never contacted, never told, never ever got an inkling that there was something wrong. So if there was anything that ever went wrong between my relationship with John or Howard or anyone back in Connecticut, it's on their side. They let it build up. They let the resentment build up on their side without ever speaking up. And I hate to say it, but in real life, if you're mature, if you are a man, you will speak up about an issue. You will not let it linger and resent and build and fester into some kind of a negative thing where you don't want to talk to someone again. And then you're going to even at some points talk shit about them and stuff. See, I would never do that because I have no reason to talk shit about people who I have always had a great relationship with. So for me, I have no clue if there's any negativity, any resentment. I have no idea, and I'm still in the dark to this day. So that's why when people ask me straight up, what's up with John Rambo? I say, ask John Rambo, because I have no clue. I'm literally in the dark. Nothing was ever brought up. And unless John kept mailing me letters and they went to a dead address, but he didn't realize it. So I didn't know he had a problem with me. No, obviously I'm just being silly. No, it just never happened. So I have no idea. I mean, I'm literally in the dark. That's the bottom line. That's the whole situation. There is no situation. I don't know. And it's a shame. It's a shame because that was a long-standing relationship that I had. You know, the mid-2000s, I met John, and whether it was Street Fighter or us just doing other stuff on YouTube, I always had a blast with him. So I don't know what his problem is, and I have no control over it. He doesn't talk to me anymore. He won't even respond. If I text him or call him, I don't get anything back. So from my situation, from my perspective, it's not even a relationship anymore. It's over, and it's 100% on him because I had nothing to do with it.